Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidjar, a retired lecturer in Mythology, Preaching, Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to give the why Christ Jesus picked up his laborers. Now Christ Jesus, you know, picked up his 11 laborers. 12th, the Judas Iscariot got himself picked up for his knowledge of 3 hours. So Christ Jesus did not have disciples. They were laborers working to be prepared to work for the vineyard of God. And this vineyard of God is the spiritual education, spreading the word of God, which the apostles did. So Christ Jesus trained them to become apostles in the vineyard of God, and the training certificate was given to them at the Last Supper, which was the last feeding to the 12 laborers, one missing, Judas Iscariot. So then he took the bread that broke it. This is my body. You know, the body is flesh. So babies, they feed on milk. When you grow up, you feed on flesh. So that is the bread that Christ Jesus has given us, which is the body of Jesus, the flesh. No more milk of John the Baptist. And then he took this wine, that this is my covenant, new covenant. So the wine he brewed was given, the method was given at Cana, how the new wine could be prepared. You need to have new skin, which is to be washed clean of the old ideas. As he got the stone vats washed away with water by the laborers over there. Then he asked them to fill fresh water, and that's how he turned the new wine. So you must have new ideas, fresh ideas, leaving behind your old education, old tricks. So the wisdom of man cannot lead you anywhere, but you have to go by the wisdom of our Mother, Holy Spirit. Christ Jesus had handpicked 11, whilst the 12th, Judas Iscariot, God himself picked up for the knowledge of 3 hours. Christ Jesus was the anointed royal priest of God, in which there is neither male nor female, Gentile or Jew, etc. Then why Jesus picked up 12 men and no woman? Now this I have explained already, that those 12 had nothing to do with the 12 tribes which these satanic, messianic Jews corrupted, and they put everything as if the Jewish people are special people, and all the other people are stupid. It is the other way around. The Gentile, they were the spiritual people, and these messianic people, they were dead of letters. So that's how they bring in the letters into the church, written Torah, to keep them bogged down in letters, whereas Jesus told them not to bring in. So these 12, why they were men, they were nothing to do with 12 tribes. There were 7 in the name of John the Baptist. You know, 7-candled menorah? Now these 7, they are all supposed to be men, no women. And 5 were in the name of Christ Jesus. Spiritual. because those 12, when they were workers in the vineyard of God being trained, they were baptizing men in water, not Jesus himself baptized. So they had to do the job of the John the Baptist. And so they were all 12 were men, not a woman. Woman cannot teach, but she can preach gospel. So when they were doing the job of John the Baptist, it was teaching like a schoolmaster. So they are all supposed to be men. 7 in the name of John the Baptist, 5 in the name of Christ Jesus, because 5 are the temptation of heart, which are also the 5 husbands of the Samaritan woman. So the 12 laborers, they were laborers, not disciples. John the Baptist had disciples. Here they were laborers. What mystery was revealed at Cana when Christ Jesus brewed the new wine? Now that mystery was that the stone vat is up, and if you want to contain the new wine, then you must get rid of the old
wine altogether. Not even the bit of yeast left in that. So that's why he asked the people over there to wash the stone vats that contain the old wine. That means the people who had the knowledge of the knowledge of the written Torah. So these people who are written Torah is old wine. Oral Torah is the new wine. New wine was missing in that the rabbis, so that's why Jesus had to come. So he told them, first get rid of this old wine, which is the letters of the written Torah. Like the Gentiles, they could not read and write. Or the born blind person, he could not read and write. So his skin was a new skin, capable of holding the new wine. So those vats were washed clean of the old wine, so not a speck left in that one. So then fresh water was poured. Fresh water means that you should be morally sound, because water is deal with our physical body and sins. So then it was turned into the new wine. So why Jesus walks ahead of his flock while John the Baptist behind his flock? Now Christ Jesus is the light, and his light is seen by the twice born people, not by the once born people. Once born people, they need guidance. John the Baptist was dealing with the once born people, so he must walk behind the flock so that they don't go astray. They don't know their ways because they are baby children being fed on milk. While those who are twice born and they are sensible and they can perceive Christ in their hearts, they do not follow anyone, but they go for the light. Anywhere, if there's a light, they will go for it, and they will not follow anyone blindly. So that's why Christ Jesus is our light, and he is walking ahead. And if you are aware of the light, of the quality of light, then you will go for it and not follow Jesus blindly. So in the next video, I will explain the next part. So it's very interesting. and you should be able to grasp a lot.